Namaskar, I am Rupak Kulkarni from Bombay, India, and I play the Bansuri, which is known everywhere in the universe. As you know, in India we have two types of Shastriya Sangeet, that is classical music. One is North Indian, the other is South Indian or Carnatic. North Indian music is mostly played in the northern part of India. It is known as Uttar Hindustani Sangeet. And Carnatic Sangeet, which is played in South India, the southern part of India, is known as South Indian music or Carnatic music. So basically, I am a North Indian musician. I play Bansuri. I think Bansuri is known since ages. This is the most ancient and a prime instrument in Indian culture. As you know, Bhagavan Shri Krishna invented or made this Bansuri. And I'm very thankful to him because he has made such an instrument which doesn't need anything except the breath. You can see there is no strings, no skin, nothing. You don't have to keep anybody to do this. This is the most natural instrument. And I think this is the most cheapest instrument in the world. And just take a bamboo, cut it, make the holes and play it. This is so simple to make, but it's not easy to play that much, because if you can practice on this, you can gain the mastery on the instrument. Bansuri has so many variations, you know. I mean, you must have seen Bansuri in almost all parts of the world, everywhere in the world, maybe in different forms. But today I'm going to explain about this Bansuri, which is a hollow piece of bamboo, nothing inside. Just one side is blocked with a cork. This is a mouthpiece from where we blow. And these are six holes where we put the fingers and produce the sur or notes. Now, Bansuri, why it is called Bansuri? In Hindi, Bansuri means the bans which produces the sur. Bans means bamboo. Sur means the notes. So the notes which are produced from the bamboo is known as Bansuri. And Bansuri has different names. Some call it Pavi. Pavi is small, or Murli, which you see in the hands of Shri Krishna. And the other thing is, this is very unique instrument, you know. I mean, you can play in this way or this way. If you are righty, you can play in the right hand. The left hand is up, the right hand is down. It's righty. And if you are playing lefty, the right hand is up and the left hand is down. So you don't have to make, like if you want to play guitar, if somebody is lefty, he has to make guitar for him. But for Bansuri, there is nothing. You can just play from either sides. Only thing, you have to make some minor adjustments in Jawari. If you are playing righty, you have to make a Jawari this side. And if you are lefty, you have to make Jawari opposite side. And if you can make Jawari both sides, anybody can play this instrument. So this is very simple instrument, very easy to carry. And I don't know how I started this Bansuri playing, because when I was very young, I just heard the sound of Bansuri from the great master Pandit Hari Prasad Chaurasia. Eventually he became my guru, and I think he's such a guru that I wish everybody should get a guru like this, because one thing he did was he never treated me like his student. He treated me like I was his son, and he took me everywhere with him, wherever he went, and it was like a new modern way of guru shishya parampara. Like in ancient times, Shishya used to stay with Guru, do his seva, and then Guru used to teach free of charge. Same like that. I used to do his seva, he taught me free of charge. He never charged any money for me. So I'm very grateful to him. And of course, the level he has taken Bansuri to such an extent that I think it's very difficult to sustain for others. But Bansuri is made by the god, so it has a never-ending life. It will never die. Now I will show you how to hum the Bansuri and how to produce a sur. Right-handed, but I would like to introduce my student, disciple, who is learning from me since he was, I think, 5 or 6 years old. Now, since 10 years, he is with me, and he plays the left-hand bansuri. So, Varad, can you play? Profession is you need a dedication, devotion, and respect to the elders. You have to obey your guru. Whatever he says, you have to obey him. Then you achieve a certain extent of performance or awareness in your life. So this is not only for bansuri, for any other profession, any other music. And you have to keep listening different genres of music, different kinds of music. If you are a flutist, you have to listen the sitar, the sarod, the vocal. And if you are a vocalist, you have to at least know how to play the percussions or tabla. And if you are a sitarist, you have to listen vocal. So basically, in any instrument, we try to imitate the vocal portion. So because the 7 notes are same in any kind of music, and we want to just reproduce what the voice can sing. And I think bansuri is the most nearest to the voice, because voice comes from here, comes out, and also the brain comes from here. So only thing is we are going to have words, but we have sur which we can produce through the bansuri. Types of flutes. See, you must be seeing these different sizes of flute. But let me tell you that bansuri or the flute is you can found in each and every part of the world. Like in USA or in Europe, you can see the key flutes, which has the flute with the keys. In India, we have just a bamboo. Bamboo, and in Southeast, if you go to Japan or China, they have shakuhachi or Chinese flute. So in various forms, you can find this instrument, which is very unique. Now I come to the size or the types of flutes. The one which I'm having is around 10 inches, but this is in A. But the one you can find is also in F, which is around 6 inch, this small. And the holes are same, like 1 plus 6, 7. And this one is in D, which is around 32 to 34 inches. But you can find the bigger one also is in B, so it normally goes to 37 inches. And the one which we use for the concert is this E bansuri. This is around 30 inches. Now the second position. As you can see, this is a natural normal position, which we say this is a sahaj asana. You have to just sit upright. show you the fingering techniques. The fingering depends on your physique. I mean, you have to think how your body is, how your physique is, how your fingers are. So according to your fingers, you have to think and develop your own fingering technique, like the great, like Bernoulli. He had a very long fingers, so he used to hold the bansuri like this on the tips. There is a myth that he had to cut his fingers and to hold the bansuri, but it's not true. And even my guru Pandit Haripasa Chaurasia, he has a long fingers, but his way of technique, fingering technique, is like this. I think this is a very sophisticated technique and very natural and very easiest way to hold the instrument, because just you take the flute and play. You don't have to adjust anything here or in the fingers. So this was the right hand side fingering techniques, like the first upper ones, you have to hold, close the holes with this, and the third one is this, the tip. Same for this right hand, like and with these thumbs, you get a nice grip and you can play it very easily. And your head should be not like this or this like this, just naturally. And also, if the bansuri is small, you can use same like this. You don't have to change your fingering. So for lefty, I asked Bharat to play, show the technique for the fingering. It's the same, it's like mirror image, you can see. Pitch in concert, we play in E. This is E bansuri. But if you are younger one, say age of 9, I think to start playing flute is the appropriate age to begin to start flute is around 8 to 9 years, because you have some power to blow. So that age you can start playing with the C sharp flute, like this size, or even the smaller one. But when you grow older to 13, 14 years, you can shift to G sharp or E, like, or G, this flute. And once you are a major, 17, 18 years, then you can start this with the E flute. The reason to play this E in the concert is that in this bansuri, we can get a very good bass notes and also very good high notes. If we play F, we cannot get that much nice bass which we can get in E, but we can get a good high octave. And if we get a D one like this, the down one note down to the E, we can get nice B, nice bass, but the higher octave is not that nice to listen. It doesn't sound that good. So I think E is a perfect pitch for the concert. And as you grow older, you know, about 70, 75, then maybe you can start going up, like F sharp or F. So you don't have to play much, you don't have to blow much. And this is, E is, I think, the universal pitch for bansuri. Also, I think in Western music, they play the key flute, and it's of this size of G side, G note. But for Indian music, I think E is the best. And if you want to play the folk tunes, then you have to go for the smaller ones, like G small or A. And also the pitch changes according to the size and length of the bansuri. The the more longer the bansuri, the more bass the sound. Like, this is the given. Now I take one key up, one note up, this E. Now I go to one half octave up, one and a half notes up, that's G. This is G one. Now you can feel that as we go up, the size of the bansuri becomes small and the pitch also goes high. Now I move to C. Now I move to the D sharp one. Now the G one. The smallest one which I have in this is A one. Now you can imagine that with this small bansuri, you can play a very nice folk tunes, and with this even we can play a nice raga. Now I will just demonstrate a small piece of folk tune. Show you how to produce the notes, the sur from the bansuri. So out of these six holes, if we close three, keep three open, we can get the sa, the main shruti, the main note. Now if we lift one finger, this is re. Another one more finger up goes to ga, gandhar. And all fingers up, like a stiver amount. Now if we close all the fingers, this is pa, Now just one finger up from the gum. Two fingers up, four close. This is mi sharp, and the upper one. This three finger close, and we can get the upper sa, the high octave sa. So as you go from bass to high octave, you have to move from the abdomen or stomach to the chest like this. So like this we can get 2 to 2.5 octaves on the bansuri. Now watch carefully how to play the sa, the sargam, sa re ga ma pa dha ni. This is sa, three fingers close, three up. Now re. Now the fingers close. This was pa. Now dha. And ni. Upper sa. So this was ascending way, now I show you the descending way. Arohi, now avrohi. Upper sa, now ni. Now daivat, dha. Now pancham, pa. Now tirama. Shuddhaga. Shuddhare. Now one thing, when you are shifting from sa to re to ga, you don't have to shift your position of the blowing, you know, not like this, just through your breath, through your breathing and finger, you have to be coordinated in mind, body and soul in the fingers. Now this was fingering, but before fingering comes the blowing. So this is the mouthpiece. We have very hard to blow inside it, not outside, right? No. You can't blow too much increase also. It should be a middle point, you know. And should not be very harsh, not too soft. But it should be like if you had something on your hand and you do like this. It's like it should be soothing. So how soothing? Like this. you are requesting something, somebody, please do this, like that. Not ordering or not, you know, just getting, going back. So I asked Varad to demonstrate the blowing first and then the left hand fingering. See, the half horn is closed, half is open. So when blowing, it should be like that, half closed, half open. Then you get a nice sound. If you do inside, it goes out of tune. And if you get too much outside, you listen the blowing sound. That is not so good for the ears. So it should be in between, and the air should go inside, in between the holes, the mouthpiece. Now where do you play sa, re, ga, tirama, pa, dha, mi, sa. Now avahi. You have to sing from inside. If you don't sing from inside, you are just like playing a gay man playing something. I mean, you cannot feel anything because Bansuri is so close to nature that you have to feel when playing it. If I blow this Bansuri, it will play, it will sound different, and if Varad plays, it will sound different. You can check this. Like I am playing. Now this Bansuri I am playing since 4 to 5 years, so after practicing on this 3-4 months continuously, I got used with this Bansuri. Now Varad will play and you can find here the difference. See, for him this, the pitch is going a bit sharp because of his physique, his fingering and his blowing. So depends on how you blow, and if I play his Bansuri, it may not sound that good. For me, when I am playing pa, the pa is a flat for me. So I have to adjust while playing his Bansuri. So if you practice as much as you can get tuned to, the body can be get tuned with the Bansuri and it will sound very nice.